Manzanillo, in the Dominican Republic. We fly into Puerto Plata and there take the car to Manzanillo, a two-hour drive through small villages along the coast. First we check into a small hotel in Monte Cristi, some 10 miles from Manzanillo, and the only one in the area. There I will meet an engineer from the UK who has to do an underwater survey of the pier. Every morning at sunrise, the engineer and myself have a quick cup of coffee at a small counter outside on the street. There, swarms of kids will be waiting for us, each with their own shoeshine box. And believe me, competition is heavy. But when you see their smiles, who could refuse? They are fun to watch. And they do a good job too. Then, for a few extra pesos, they will even do your car. Oh boy, talking about manpower. And then to know, it is only a rental. With shining shoes and a clean car, we now hit the road for Manzanillo. It's only a 15-minute drive with a few passing cars, but lots of animals. I have never seen so many goats in my life, and remember, they consider the roads their territory, so don't expect them to wait for you at the crossings. If you have to drive at night time, we recommend you go 5 miles an hour. And if you don't watch, this is what can happen to you. Although, as we were told, most of the casualties are people on motorcycles. You see what I mean? The streets are unpaved, and all over town we find animals crossing the streets, including pigs. So driving slow is certainly a wise thing to do. Most of the inhabitants make their living in the banana plantations, or on the waterfront, either by working on the ships or by deep sea fishing. The waterfront is a finger pier and can handle only one ship at a time. When we arrive, the labor is waiting on the dock because the ship has not yet arrived. And since it is Saturday, also some of the village people have come down, just out of curiosity. Okay. While we wait, we get a diving demonstration from a bunch of local kids. They will dive for your peso, but if you don't have one, they will do it anyway, just for fun.
Okay.
Here we go!
These kids don't know any danger. They climb over and under the pier construction like little rats. The engineer was well prepared for this, because he had taken his fishing gear with him.
All of a sudden, everything starts pulling.
But the fishing will not last long, because the ship is in sight. The pilot is sent out by launch to meet her. Due to the bad structural condition of the pier, the captain has to take it very easy during the approach. From the dock, we will give the captain by radio advice and recommendations during the mooring procedures. This is a view from the bridge during the docking procedures. Different from the previous port we visited before, we will load here out of rail cars. But first we will discharge a cargo of new empty cartons destined for the packing houses. There is no shortage of labor, but it is sometimes not very clear who is the leader. They all give directions, which at times is very confusing, as you will see here.
Go,
Once we have discharged the cartons, we will start loading the bananas. Train loads with fresh bananas will arrive at the dock straight from the plantation. The bananas are randomly checked by an inspector, and he is sometimes joined by the captain, because he wants to know what quality they load in his vessel.
Yeah, ship starboard, eh?
Yeah. 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch! 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch!
The manual handling in Manzanillo is a far cry from the mechanical loading in Guatemala. Here, it's all muzzle power.
A beautiful bunch, a ripe banana. Hide the deadly black tarantula.
Live 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch. 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch.
Once the vessel is loaded and the documents have been delivered on board, she undocks and sails for the UK. And the locals return home, waiting for the next vessel. Our story ends here, and we hope that next time when you peel a banana, you think about us and how the yellow fruit ended up in your shopping bag.